Developing Assessment Instruments for Endorsement. Chapter 1, Preparing to Develop Assessment Instruments. This presentation is recorded in three chapters. This chapter covers the pre-reading, familiarisation with QCAA resources, and reflection on previously developed assessment instruments that is recommended before you begin to develop assessment instruments for a new cohort of students. Chapter 2 will explain how to access and use the assessment templates, as well as the features of the endorsement application that help you to quality assure your assessment instruments before you submit them for endorsement. Finally, Chapter 3 will outline where you can find additional support and information when developing your assessment instrument and as it progresses through the endorsement process. A number of resources are available to help you to develop endorsable assessment instruments in the provided assessment templates. Before you begin to develop your assessment instruments, we recommend that you familiarise yourself with these resources. Now I'll step you through the various resources and where to find them in the QCAA portal. First and foremost is your syllabus, which can be accessed via the syllabus application. The syllabus describes the units of work and assessment specifications, and it also includes resources to guide you as you develop assessment, including sample internal assessment instruments, subject reports that outline the findings of the previous year's endorsement, confirmation, and external assessment processes, and other quality assurance resources. Once you have located your syllabus, from this location, to access these resources, click on the green resources button at the top right of the screen. You can also access the contact details for QCAA staff for your subject. Under the Unit 3 and 4 tab, you can find sample assessment instruments to help you to develop your assessment instrument. You should not copy the sample assessment instruments to use as your own, but use them as a guide to develop an assessment instrument that is suitable for your students and the learning experiences that they will engage in. Under the Quality Assurance heading, you will find quality assurance tools for each assessment instrument and guidelines for developing and reviewing assessment. This document provides advice about the amount and types of changes recommended from one year's assessment to the next. While the endorsement application allows schools to copy an assessment instrument from one year to another, it is very important that schools revise their assessment instruments to ensure that student responses are authentic, limiting opportunities for plagiarism, to ensure assessment security, and to consider ways to improve their assessment instruments. You will also find information about what is expected to be included in the submission at both endorsement and confirmation. Before developing assessment, the confirmation submission guidelines are also a recommended read, as this may influence how you direct students to produce their response. There is also an additional resources tab that includes copies of the subject reports, information about cognitive verbs, and other subject-specific resources. The endorsement application is another valuable source of information. Retained in this application is a record of all previous endorsed and comparable assessment instruments for your school. This also includes the directives for assessment instrument versions that were not endorsed, so that you can reflect on that advice before you begin to develop new assessment. Located in the endorsement app are the quality assurance tools, also used by endorsers to guide decisions about your submitted assessment instruments. There are a range of ICT resources that can be accessed by clicking on the help link when you are working in the endorsement application. In the application, you can see the directives for each assessment instrument by opening the assessment instrument. It is also possible to run a report that collects all previous endorsement decisions and directives for one or more subjects and for one or more assessment techniques. Submitters and approvers have access to run an endorsement decision report by clicking on the Reports option. The submitter or approver can select all relevant subjects, completion years, and assessment instruments to create a downloadable, tailored report. The report identifies that the assessment instrument was endorsed, first, second, or intervention, and the directives that were provided if the assessment instrument was not endorsed. These directives can help you plan so that you don't replicate the same issues in your new assessment. there are still more resources to be found in the QCAA portal. At this time, the key resources I will draw your attention to are the assessment literacy resources, the QCE and QCIA Policy and Procedures Handbook, and the resources in the Learning Hub. The QCE and QCIA Policy and Procedures Handbook can be accessed in two ways and two formats. From the QCAA website homepage by selecting the link to Senior Secondary, then clicking on the Handbook link. This takes you to a web-based copy of the handbook. Or it can be accessed from the notice board in the QCAA portal as a PDF file. The handbook outlines all policies and procedures that relate to the achievement of the QCE or QCIA for students in the senior phase of learning. The handbook includes sections about the endorsement process, administering internal assessment, including scaffolding, feedback and drafting, managing response length and authenticating students' responses, and access arrangements and reasonable adjustments, ARA, including illness and misadventure. This is important information to consider as you begin to draft your assessment instrument. The assessment literacy application offers courses on key concepts. Module 1, attributes of quality assessment, and Module 2, developing valid and accessible assessment. The Learning Hub includes short courses about academic integrity and courses related to teaching and learning that underpin assessment. Completing these courses not only provides valuable learning, but can also be claimed as part of compulsory professional learning hours for teacher registration. The QCAA also uses social media to share information about upcoming events, activities, and resources.